Made in the USA does work. We're committed to making it work here in Conover, North Carolina. We're in it for the long haul.
That's the rallying cry of manufacturers in Conover, North Carolina, where some textile companies are hanging on. According to data from the Bureau of Labor, the area has lost more than 14,000 jobs in the past few decades to automation and cheap labor offshore. Here in the foothills of the Appalachian Mountains, the Manufacturing Solutions Center is passing on the tradition of textile manufacturing to a new generation of entrepreneurs and workers.
For us, we moved the company here from Florida. There's definitely no textiles left in Florida. So to be here where there's sort of some residual textiles in the education system and then in the people, in Florida there is definitely no option. I mean, you're 2 weeks from on a truck from anybody.
The center helps entrepreneurs test ideas, model products, and ultimately connect them to large-scale domestic manufacturers. Their goal is to bring textile jobs back to the area, and they're training the next generation of textile workers.
The biggest challenge is getting young people trained on the technical jobs before we lose all the real skilled technical people that are out there.
But the businesses hiring today look very different than the ones that were here in the 90s. Instead of large, dusty factories, businesses are smaller, highly automated, and doing crazy things with yarn. Take, for example, Jordan Schindler. He's binding medicine to yarn.
You start with a package of yarn, whether it's nylon, cotton, polyester, and almost like a sponge, the yarn is absorbing these active ingredients. And then from there, you're left with, let's say, a package of menthol yarn or aspirin yarn or tea tree oil yarn, which can then get knit or woven into a sock like the sock I'm wearing. So instead of having to apply Icy Hot every couple hours while you're running a big race or playing a big game, you just wear your sock.
Today, even making a regular sock requires skilled workers that understand how to program, run, and maintain the machines.
The technology that goes into a sock is amazing. You know, no one ever thinks about it.
These machines can make a sock 2.5 times faster than before.
You know, I hear the term advanced manufacturing all the time. If you're in business today making stuff and in manufacturing, you're going to be advanced. Now it's all computerized and you have robots that close the toe on the machine where you used to have sewers.
Lauren Brawlier is part of this new generation of workers. She's learning to operate a flatbed knitting machine.
So we just finished the medium left sock. So I'm going to finish the medium left, and now I'm going to upload the medium right from our program on the flash drive that he's already created.
Mark Bess, on the other hand, has worked in textiles all his life. He's from Conover, and after being laid off several times by businesses moving offshore, he's finally found a home at U Apparel, a compression sock manufacturer. They moved back to the area because they wanted to make Made in the USA part of their brand.
We have all the resources here. We have the people here. We have everything we need here. And we're going to make it work.
It's about community. It's about community. And it's, I coach a swim team. I've watched kids grow up, and they're like my own as a while. And I'd like for them to stay here if they want to.